Hi, it's Sandy Wiley. Welcome to my mental health channel, where I wipe away the stigma of mental illness by talking about my own personal struggles, having borderline personality disorder, post-traumatic stress disorder, anxiety and panic attacks, depression. I talk about narcissism and my narcissistic mother who used to abuse me terribly. I talk about schizophrenia. And I wrote a book about my schizophrenic father, Life with My Schizophrenic Father. And the links are below in the description. It's available on Amazon. I write about all my unethical psychologists who sexually exploited and abused me. And the links to those books are also in the description. And those are available on Amazon. I talk about a plethora of other mental related topics. And I only talk about them as a former patient of almost 20 years. I am not a licensed therapist. I do not hold a degree in psychology, so I cannot diagnose you or even give you a professional opinion. All I ask in turn of you is your kindness and respect. Please be kind to me, respectful to other people who comment. We don't need to agree on everything. Variety is the spice of life, but we always need to show each other respect and kindness in the comments. Now, if you are new to my channel, welcome, welcome. Hit that little box on the lower right-hand corner that says subscribe. That way you will be notified every time a new video comes on. It's 100% free. So stick around, take a chance. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. Share with your friends and your family on your social medias. Please feel free to comment and share with me your personal experiences, your opinions, your struggles, what you're going through, your feelings, your emotions. I would be very happy to hear from you, and I will always answer you. And let's grow the love, spread the love, and, you know, become friends and have a community here on my channel where we don't have to feel alone in our personal struggles. That's the whole point of this, of my channel, so people don't have to feel alone. Today's video topic of discussion is, why do I do that? Why do I always blame myself for things, you know? Why do I take responsibility for other people? Why do I feel like I'm the one to blame? Do you ever feel like that? If your friend is having a bad day, or your lover or partner or anything, your child, your parent, whoever it is, even a coworker, do you feel responsible when someone else is upset? It might have nothing to do with you. As a borderline, I have borderline personality disorder. I'm very intuitive into people's moods, and I take them very personally. Other people can brush it off and say, oh, you know, that person's just having a bad day, but I don't brush things off. If someone is having a bad day or something, I feel responsible. I feel like, what did I do wrong? What did I say? And right away, I'm jumping in with the apologies. Do you do that? I'm sorry. I'm sorry you're upset. Even if I did nothing wrong, even if I did absolutely nothing wrong, I'm jumping in with the apologies because I feel responsible for someone else's feelings. And so it puts the extra added emotional baggage on me. So, like, in other words, I'm already carrying my own emotional baggage. And then when someone else looks upset, even if it has nothing to do with me, just say they're having a bad day, someone cut them off in traffic, then I'm carrying on their emotions too. So now I'm like doubling the weight on my back. And I've done this in therapy too. I've done this with psychologists. As you know, if you watch my other videos, I had unethical, immoral relationships, sexual relationships with therapists that I should not have gotten into, but I have felt responsible for them. And it was a dual role reversal where I became their therapist. I was paying money to talk about my problems because they're the doctor They're the one who has a professional license. But I felt so responsible for them that I was paying them coming in as a patient seeking help, but I was sitting in the therapy sessions listening to their problems. And this happened all the time with Dr. James Barbaria. I would come in, I would listen to his problems. He would tell me about how he was mistreated as a little boy. He had a narcissistic mother too, like me, who ignored him for weeks on end. If, you know, over the least little thing, if he didn't like the meal she presented, she would say nothing. She would not talk to him, completely ignore him. The father used to beat him severely, almost hospitalized him once. He almost died once from his father's beating. So he would come in, my psychologist, and he would tell me all these things. He'd talk about his former girlfriends that hurt him. One he was with for 5 years just said she needed space. She needed a few weeks away from him, some time. And then after that, he called her and she didn't want nothing to do with him. She dumped him. I mean, he would go on and tell me graphic details. And I was his patient. I was supposed to be opening up to him, telling him my problems. But instead, because I felt so responsible, you know, I would listen to him. I would blame myself for people not being happy. I would, do you ever do that? Try to crack a joke, try to make someone laugh. In fact, I would blame myself when I was a young child and my mother would, you know, beat me up, or I would blame myself because, you know, I'd be crying because I didn't pick up toys. I left toys out on the floor and she'd be, you know, she'd go into a fit of rage if her house wasn't spotless, wasn't immaculate. Like, you couldn't leave, I mean, anything out. Not, you couldn't leave a doll out on the couch. That would make her have a conniption fit. She would beat me up. She would break the doll, snap it in half. So, of course, I grew up feeling responsible for other people. I felt like, you know, oh, a little girl, like a 3 or 4 year old, you know, I don't know how old I was because I blocked out a chunk of my memory. I'm just saying I was young or whatever. And she would do these things. She would break my toys. She would throw my toys out if I didn't pick them up. If I left one thing out. I don't mean like, you know, dump everything out into like a... But so this is why I felt responsible. And then, you know, I blame myself for everything. And I would take it out on myself by overeating. A lot of people don't believe this who see me nowadays because I'm physically fit nowadays. Now I have an alcohol problem instead because of my... I was raped by my psychologist. But back then, the way that I took out my feelings and other people who mistreated me was through food. I would eat, you know, and I would get fat and, you know, I'd be really chunky. I said I'm 5'2". I went up to 175 pounds before I was pregnant. When I was pregnant, I went up to 200 pounds. But I'm not going to tell you that was I'm carrying a 9.5 pound baby boy at that point. I'm talking about before I was pregnant. I went up to 175 pounds. And, you know, I just ate and ate because I blame myself. I'll never forget that the first time I got pregnant, it ended in a miscarriage. And I went into a very, very deep depression after that. And I talked about that in other videos, how I didn't leave the house for, I don't know, a long, long time. I put a mattress on the living room floor, put the shades down. And if you ever had a deep depression where you didn't even want to shower or get out of bed, that was me. I just ate. I just would eat and sleep, watch TV, eat, sleep, watch TV. That's it, all day long, and do nothing except get fatter and fatter and fatter and fatter. Well, before that depression, losing that baby, that pregnancy got me into that horrible, horrible funk. I was pregnant and I had sex like people do with my husband. And then right after sex with him, I started spotting. And I blamed myself because I had sex and I started spotting. I called the doctor and told him what happened. And he said, oh, it's a lot of women spot. Don't worry about it. You know, brushed me off. And then it started getting heavier. And then I started bleeding. And I called the doctor again. And I told him. And he said, oh, well, you know, as long as you're not feeling pain, you don't have to worry about it. Well, guess what? I was feeling a lot of pain. And I'm like doubled over like this. And I go, you know, no, I'm not feeling pain. I was complete denial. Okay, I was having a miscarriage. And the doctor denied it and denied it. Well, I wasn't 100% truthful. I told him I was bleeding, but I didn't tell him I was. I did not tell him I was in pain. So severe pain and bleeding. And then I expelled the pregnancy. But I felt so guilty that I kept stuffing down, you know, all those feelings, like repressing them down with food. So I would eat and eat and sleep all day and eat and sleep. And then get this, after that, I couldn't get pregnant for 2 years. I was infertile after that pregnancy. So I really blamed myself. And the doctor said it was, you know, I was the infertile one. My husband was blast off. My husband had so much sperm. He was like an elephant. So the infertility was totally on my problem. So again, I blame myself. First, you know, I'm the cause of why we can't have children, not my husband, because he was tested and his sperm was in the zillions. Plus, they were very mobile. They were, you know, he was a very healthy, sexually high-functioning man who didn't have any problem. It was me. When I finally did get us pregnant and having a baby, I had the miscarriage. You know, I expelled the pregnancy. So when I finally did get pregnant with my son, Alex, I told my husband I'm not having any sex during my pregnancy. So I had no sex during the whole 9 month pregnancy with Alex. And I had no sex during the whole 9 month pregnancy with Austin. And the reason why I didn't have sex during those two pregnancies is because I miscarried right after having sex the first time I got pregnant. I don't think having sex brought on the miscarriage. A lot of women, 1 out of 4 women have a miscarriage in their life. It's very common. But I associated that, you know, I'm not going to do anything at all. I'm not going to have any pleasure during these pregnancies, you know, because I blame myself for that miscarriage. So I didn't have sex. I only ate healthy. Of course, I didn't drink, not one drink, not one. The whole 9 months on both pregnancies. I didn't, you know, I laid on the couch. I eat fruits and vegetables. I was afraid to even exercise or do anything that could, you know, because I blame myself. There I go again. I blame myself for that miscarriage, especially because I had sex. And right after sex, I miscarried. So I associated, you know, doing anything physical with miscarrying the baby. So I didn't do anything. But I blame myself for that. I blame myself as a child that, you know, I was too much for my mother. She even blamed me. She said I was responsible for ruining her life. Those are her exact words. She said, if I didn't have you, I wouldn't have to stay with your father. See, so I felt responsible. I took the weight on of all my mother's problems. I took the weight on of all my psychologist's problems, even though I was his patient. I took the weight on of everything and blame myself. It might be part of my borderline personality to do this. I don't know if you guys out there who have borderline personality disorder, if you blame yourself or feel responsible for other people, their feelings or whatnot, what they're going through, you take it on yourself that, you know, you feel to blame. So this started as a little girl, and it continued when I was an adult trying to have children of my own. And it continued in my therapies with my psychologists. And so now at 59 years old, I come to the realization that, you know, I'm not responsible for other people. All right. I'm not responsible for your feelings. If you're not feeling happy or you're not having a good day, I'm not responsible. So I learned this late in life. Okay. I learned this through trial and error. I have enough of my own, you know, hurts, wounds, traumas, scars that I don't need to carry anyone else's wounds and scars. You know, I have to be only responsible for myself and my own feelings, you know. Now, that doesn't mean I go out of my way to make someone else feel bad. You know, I'm going to be polite. I'm going to be kind. I'm going to be respectful to other people. But if they're having a bad day or they're carrying their own wounds and scars, I'm not going to let myself feel responsible for that, you know. So I just thought I would go on here and talk about that, because I think it might be common with other people too, that other people feel responsible for people's feelings or feel responsible for things in their life when it isn't their fault. And they just put that extra burden upon themselves when they feel this way. So I just want to let you know, you're only responsible for yourself. You're not responsible for someone else, okay? So right now, if you're feeling bad about someone, or, you know, a relationship went bad and you feel like it's your fault, you know, you can't take the blame for everything. You have enough on your own plate. You can't take the blame for other people. You can't take the blame if other people don't like you. That's how I used to be too. If someone didn't like me, I would take the blame that there was something wrong with me. I'm not good enough. I would feel inadequate. I would feel like I'm ugly. I'm too ugly. I'm too fat. I'm too, you know, this or that. And I would blame myself for people not liking me. And now I don't do that. I no longer do that, because I'm not responsible for other people. I'm not responsible for their happiness. I'm not responsible if they're having a bad day. I'm not responsible for their scars, their old wounds, their past histories, their past traumas. I'm not responsible if they don't like me. They either like me or they don't like me. You know, I'm still going to be me. I'm still, you know, I'll still treat people with respect. But if people don't like me, I'm not going to wonder why or tear myself apart about it. Or take the blame that I'm unlikable, because I'm lovable and you're lovable too. And you have to believe that, all right? You're not responsible for other people. And I just want to, you know, emphasize this right now at the end of this video, because for so long, I felt like I was. And, you know, from a young child, because of the way I was treated by my mother, I was not responsible for my mother staying in her marriage. I was not, you know. I was not responsible for my mother, you know, abusing me, beating me up because I left a couple of toys out. I was not. I was not responsible for having a miscarriage because I had sex. Missionary sex. Not anything wild or kinky or far out. I was not. I'm not responsible if someone doesn't like me or, you know, is having a bad day or needs professional help, and he's a psychologist. I'm not responsible for my psychologist. If he's messed up, he needs to get his own help, not go and, you know, dump it all on a patient who's paying money for him to listen to my problems. I'm not responsible for him. I am not. I am not responsible for his patients. If I report him to the licensing board, and he has said this over and over, you're responsible, Sandra. If you take me to the licensing board because I had sex with you for 2 years, you're responsible for every one of my patients. When I lose my license, they'll have no one to go to. You're responsible. I am a patient myself. I'm not responsible for his patients. His actions brought him, you know, his unethical behavior is what made him, you know, he's responsible, you know, for his patients. He's their doctor. I'm not responsible. So it took a while for me to learn that I'm, you know, I can't blame myself and take on the responsibility of other people. And I've stopped doing it. And I just come on here to tell you, you got to stop doing it too, because it's going to destroy you. You have enough of your own shit on your plate than to take on someone else's plate too. All right. Write me. Tell me what you think. Tell me if you felt that way. If you yourself blame yourself for things, for other people's feelings, for, you know, let me know what you think in the comments. And until next time, have a great day.